The learning objectives of this section are to be acquainted with the following boiler control systems: combustion control, burner management, trip system, level control. The main objectives of the combustion control system are to supply fuel oil according to the boiler load, to control the combustion air supply according to the fuel oil consumption, to shut off the burners in case of an emergency. A cascade control system is used to obtain the best possible stability. The system is comprised of several controllers. A master controller receives the steam pressure and the steam flow signal. The output signal from the master is the input signal to the air controller and the fuel oil controller, called the slave controllers. The control philosophy is that the slave controller has to take care of the variations in the master controller output signal before this affects the master controller's input signal. The master input signal, or the process variable, is the value that has to be constant in the first place. To maintain the best possible combustion during change of boiler load, we need a high-low selector, which also receives a signal from the oxygen controller. The high-low selector makes it possible to increase the airflow before increase in fuel oil flow when we increase boiler load. As we are reducing boiler load, we want to reduce the oil flow before we reduce the airflow. By adding the signal from the oxygen analyzer, we can optimize the air-oil ratio further. This to compensate for variations in fuel oil quality, air flow due to soot, and reduced air blower capacity. Tuning of a cascade control system is usually done the following way. Set the slave controller in manual during normal operation. Tune the controller according to specifications in the operating manual. When the master controller input process variable is correct, adjust the slave controller's set point to the slave controller input signal. When this is completed, the slave controller can be switched back to auto. The master controller must be in manual during firing of the boiler. If it is necessary to tune the master controller, this must be done with the slave controller in auto or remote set point mode. Carefully follow the instructions in the manual. As each burner has a limited capacity with an optimum range, we usually have several burners on each boiler to achieve the best possible combustion under various load conditions. The burner management system will fire and shut off the burners in sequence, depending on the boiler load. One burner is selected as the master and the others are slaves. A set steam pressure deviation will activate the system. The low and high pressure limits must reflect the pressure control system settings. To avoid hazards to people and possible damage to the boiler, a shut-off or trip system is always installed. Input to the trip system can be the following signals: flame failure, combustion air failure, air preheater failure, high-high water level, low-low water level, high-high steam pressure, emergency stop activated. All the signals are wired in a separate system and are not an integrated part of the control system. The trip system requires separate pressure and level switches. to maintain the correct water level during all normal operating conditions, we need an automatic level control system. On boilers with a low steam production and a high water content, the level control system only measures the water level and controls the feed water flow by a control valve. On boilers with a high steam production and low water content, the level control system is usually based on signals from the steam consumption and the feed water supply in addition to the water level. A sudden increase in steam consumption results in a pressure drop in the steam water drum, and the water level increases and vice versa. This is why we need to compare steam consumption with the feed water supply before we introduce major changes to the feed water supply.